Hey you guys, welcome back. I thought I would do a short, and I really do mean shorter than what I've been filming, video, just to give you guys a little update on what's going on with me in case you care. I have made some changes to my channel. I've made some changes to the way I do social media, and I've addressed it a little bit here and there, but I thought it would just be helpful to make one video all about why I'm changing, what's changing, and what will happen moving forward. So one big change is, as you know, Jimmy and I, over the last year and a half, have really started to make changes to our life to simplify our life, just kind of live a life of simplicity as much as possible. And it started with downsizing our house and then downsizing our stuff. And then for me, it started going into downsizing my social media and my presence online. Not that I have a great presence online or a ton of followers or anything like that, but downsizing my time spent online and just really trying to be healthy in how I manage social media and how I manage my YouTube channel and make sure that it's balanced well with my life. And one thing, Jimmy and I actually did a talk for a MOPS group, and we shared our story on life simplicity and all that God has shown us along the way in hopes, you know, to inspire other people to make changes for themselves, whatever that looks like. It's different for everybody. But we just talked about how we're constantly checking in with ourselves, with each other, and in our prayer life, that are we being responsible with our responsibilities, our abilities, and our priorities? And you have to first know what those are. And then once you've established that, you really check in with the Lord, am I being wise with these three areas? And we just really want to live a life of intention and worship. And so for us, it just works better to have that be more simple and maybe not look like what everybody else is doing and how everyone else is doing it. And for a long time, I resisted that because I wanted to be successful, and I thought in order to be successful, I have to follow what everyone says you have to do. Post so many times, post at certain times, hashtag certain things. And every time I would strive for that, I would just feel not so great in my soul and in my heart. And once I really, really started to pray and I had a friend praying for me, I just, that desire to keep up completely went away, and I just have this total peace about the way that I am approaching it. So that was one thing that we downsized, with social media and how we spent our time on it. And pretty much I stopped Facebooking. I don't scroll through Facebook. I don't post on Facebook except for in my Beauty Perspective Facebook group. I only post on Instagram as far as a picture goes, maybe once a week, sometimes twice a week. The only social media I'm doing is Instagram stories and Snapchat. And when I'm posting, I really do have a set of questions that I go through that I make sure that it's intentional. I'm not just posting to post or to show off or anything like that. I really want it to serve the people who are watching it. So that's social media. I also really have decided to simplify my beauty world and routine. And for me, that looks like switching over from toxic products or unnatural products to completely green and non-toxic makeup, skincare, hair care. And I'll talk more about the skincare and hair care in another video, but for the most part, as far as makeup goes, it's 100% natural. And what kind of prompted that was I was sorting through all my makeup, wanting to downsize how much I had, and as I was getting rid of stuff, I'm like, I only need a few lipsticks. I only need one or two foundations. I mean, ideally, we really only need one. And as I was getting rid of everything, I was like, you know, this is the perfect time to replace this stuff with natural, safe. It was one of the last areas for me to switch over. I feel like we've done a really good job with our food, with our cleaning products. We don't take a lot of medicine. And so it was just time. So you might have noticed that my topics here and a lot on social media are showing you guys healthier alternatives, better products for you to use. And in the future, the more I learn, the more I want to share about ingredients and what you need to be aware of, maybe what you don't need to worry so much about. That's all in the future as I learn. This is definitely a learning experience for me, and there's so much to learn, and it actually gets me excited because when I share something with you guys, I know that it's really going to benefit your life and your skin and your hormones and all the things inside. It's not just going to make you look pretty, or, you know, there's more to it. So that has really ignited this excitement within me to do and talk about beauty products. But I still don't want to make a video every week. So I will probably be posting 2 videos a month, maybe 3 if I have the time. My Vitacost hauls might not be as frequent, but I'm ordering a lot of the same stuff from Vitacost anyway. So maybe a Vitacost video every other month. Same with my empties. It's a lot of the same stuff, so I might only be sharing those with you every other month as well. So those are the changes with my channel and with my makeup and my skincare and social media. And then as I started to pull back a little bit from social media and pull back a little bit from YouTube, I had this pocket of time every day where normally I would be doing YouTube stuff, or I don't know what I was doing, to be honest, but I had a pocket of time every day where I had nothing to do. And I think God had me in that place. So I would really pray and seek Him. It was a tough month there as I was transitioning out of spending so much time on social media and on my channel. And I just felt kind of blue, like kind of empty. Like, what is my purpose? I have all this time while my kids are at school and I don't feel like I'm using it well. And I don't want to watch TV during the day. I can only clean so much. And I just felt like I needed to be doing something more. Of course, I was praying about it. I was talking with Jimmy about it. And I decided that I wanted to start volunteering. I started searching out faith-based organizations that had mommy mentors, or someone who would mentor and kind of guide maybe younger women in hard times in their life. So ideally for me, because of my background with foster care, I wanted to find an organization that worked with moms who had lost their kids to foster care but were actively working to get them back, or working with maybe older teen girls, 17 and 18, as they're getting ready to age out, but they don't have a solid person in their life to help guide them into that transition of adulthood. And so I searched and I searched, and I could not find a single organization in my area that provides that to women like that. I mean, there's a lot of organizations, but you can't talk about your faith. And for me, that's really important for me to share, because I feel like you can make all these changes in your life, and the same goes with simplicity. You can make all these changes in your life, but it's not going to lead to lasting happiness and contentment and joy. That only comes from the Lord. So I want to share things that will help their life and improve their life. But if I can't share the ultimate thing that will change their life, then I just feel like I don't know. You know what I'm saying? So I ended up broadening my scope a little bit that didn't have to be necessarily tied to foster care. And I found a pregnancy center that just provides free care to women who are pregnant or think they might be pregnant, kind of counseling them through their decisions on what to do with the pregnancy, just whatever they're going through. But I ended up finding a center that had a program where you do mentor these young women, or women, I guess it could be of any age, that have chosen to have their babies, and they could be pregnant or already had their baby anywhere in that process. And I will be working with them, either teaching parenting classes or Bible studies, either one-on-one or with a small group, maybe 2 or 3 women at a time, and just really investing into them and sharing with them and going through different videos and programs and Bible studies. And I'm really, really excited. I started my training, so I've had to take a break from my biblical counseling training because it's 24 hours of videos and like a book that I have to go through to be a certified counselor for pregnancy centers. So once I have this certification, I think I can go to any pregnancy center and counsel there. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm trying to get at least 4 hours a week because I want to hurry up and learn and get in there and work with the women. And so that's where I'm at right now. And then once I finish the training, I will start the actual volunteering, and I'll be doing that 1 to 2 times a week. And then I'll go back to my biblical counseling setting, which I think I still have a good year or 2 years before I finish that. I'm not in a rush. I really want to take my time with that because it's so much wisdom and information, and I just want to soak it in. I don't want to miss anything. But as I go through that, I think that will really help me in serving the place that I will be volunteering and serving those women. It's already been benefiting me and my own spiritual walk and relationships. I think it's benefited my family as I am able to share some of the things that I'm learning as we go through different struggles or different things in our life. I just feel like this program, the Biblical Counseling Program, is invaluable. Even if you don't want to do it and get certified, I would encourage you as a believer to go through it, because I feel like as Christians, we should all be biblical counselors. So I love it. I believe in this program. It's changed my life. It's amazing. So I think that kind of brings us up to date. Maybe this wasn't as short as I had hoped, but I think that kind of gives you a good idea of what's going on in my life and why things are changing. And as always, I will keep you guys up to date on what's going on and what God is teaching me and showing me. I'm hoping to make just a faith-based video, and maybe even eventually get back to our church chat videos once a week for church chat. But as far as just an update or the things that I'm learning in my counseling, I would like to share some of that with you guys maybe once a month or once every other month. Of course, I always share little things here and there on Snapchat and Instagram stories, so that's just easy. You can just share right away. I don't have to get ready. This is work. I don't wear this much makeup normally. Like twice a week do I ever wear this much makeup. So, and sometimes when I'm not filming, it's once a week. Another change, my bangs are back. Maybe you've noticed. I just feel like I'm me. Like I'm just back. I just feel like bangs are right, you know? So that brings us up to date. I hope you guys are all doing well. Thank you so much for just being here, being a part of this community, encouraging each other. Even though there's been changes, you guys still hang out with me, and that means so much. I'm so thankful for each and every one of you. God bless you guys. Bye.